I tried changing the hair color from white to green, and it looks good. Red suits as well, and this model works well for Inpaint. Let me change the mask quickly. My prompt will be sunglasses, but then I want to see things behind a glass. A transparent word should work. These glasses won't be saving anyone from the sun. The glasses should be semi-transparent. Her eyes look accurate, but the skin had lost all the details. The eyes and this smooth section clearly shows I'm using a Flux model. And these are the new Flux model for Inpaint and Outpaint an image. This is the smaller FP8 model, sized around 12 gigabyte. Above is the larger 24 gigabyte model for larger memory cards. And this is how the inpainting works with this model. My prompt is a brown leather jacket. Now, I'm not saying this should be the final image. Of course, you need some LoRa for details, or maybe you can process the image again for more details. The next thing this model is supposed to do is outpainting, and without any prompt, this looks okay to me. I will copy the image and will use the same again for outpainting. But the image size is larger than 1024 pixels. To adjust the image size, I have added the scale image node after the image load node. Now the image introduced in the workflow will be around the recommended size and should not be a challenge for my graphics card. So I queued the workflow. I have processed the result again, which extended the image further, but the extended part looks dark. But the lower body generated is perfect. This model is better than the previous Flux-Fill model. I am back to the first workflow, and I painted the entire image, excluding the subject's face. I want the image to be proper with normal lighting, but here, the wearable got changed. This is acceptable to me, because this is not an image edit model. I uploaded the image into the Outpaint workflow. I will adjust the Outpaint sides and the length. Now, I want to create a boy in front of the woman, and I do not know whose right side will be considered here. The prompt is about a kid with balloons in his hands. The direction was considered from my side, so I will extend from the left. And it worked. The pattern on the t-shirt matches the woman's clothes. My prompt was, the child is lifted slightly off the ground, appearing to float in the air while holding onto the balloons. The subject got changed. I tried a different word. Boy instead of child. However, the kid looks different. Also, to show the boy is in the air, the subject got far enough to show the feeling of lifting off. I tried making the kid appear at the same distance by decreasing the mask area. And the kid was adjusted somehow in the small space. I will try adding a cat here. My prompt is, add a cat standing behind the laptop, positioned naturally as if curious about what's on the screen. The cat looks perfect, and I hope one of his legs is hidden behind. I tried adding a neon sign on the top left of the image, which says Flux in red. But the yellow ceiling lamps were in between, even after multiple attempts. So I decided to remove the hanging lamps. My prompt words were empty, delete, remove the yellow lights. I tried with everything I can think of, but nothing worked. The model is made to add things in the process of inpaint and outpaint. This feature makes removing objects a challenge. I had to use this LoRa to remove objects from the image. I added the LoRa loader in the workflow, selected it with its default weight, and queued the workflow. The LoRa worked, but left one lamp behind. I used the result generated and processed it again to remove the ceiling lamp. The hanging lamp was removed, but now there was a bulb. The bulb should not bother the neon lights from that distance. Also, there is a reflection on the glass that goes along with the bulb. The sign was generated, and it looks okay to me. My prompt was to add a police tactical utility vest, and it was adjusted on the body, going below her hands. but it also failed in maintaining the chest area, which looks smaller now. A police vest should also have a radio, which looks fine, but now it has become completely flat. I accepted and continued with the result and tried adding cargo pants. The sweater's hands are not in a circle now, but that is due to the mask I painted. Also, the position of her legs has been changed. I corrected my mask paint on the left, and then the lower section became perfect. A zombie is approaching from the blocked door, mouth open and blood dripping from the face. The zombie generated blends well with the overall image. This model is not a game changer. Also, do not mistake this as an edit model. We have Flux Context for editing. As per my understanding, this model is for Inpaint and Outpaint only, and it is slightly better than the Flux-Fill. The workflow is nothing special. You should get the Outpaint workflow in the templates. I was using this in the video, and this is the workflow I was using to Inpaint. I kept the guidance around 40 to 50, which may look unusual, but the other values were at default. And I made the character as she was before. Words like big, thick, and fluffy should work in such cases. So that is it in this video. I hope you have an excellent day.